Just leave.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. There may be nothing that the chief operating officer can do about this situation. Kevin Nash will man up, and he will fight.
Please, please, please don't leave. See, I'm out here right now to get to the bottom of this. Who sent the text message? Well, it seems we got a mystery on our hands, so why don't we play a little bit of game of Clue. Was it Big Lazy with the giant tuba just for men in the conservatory? Maybe. Or was it Triple H backstage with his trusty sledgehammer? Or maybe, and this is the one my money's on, maybe it was Stephanie McMahon. You know, I don't know, with a candlestick in the library or something. We need to figure out who sent the text message, gentlemen, because I don't believe a word either of you are saying right now. And Nash, you came out here to apologize to me last week. You should have just apologized. And now you say I crossed the line. Well, guess what? I'm a habitual line stepper. That's what I do. I step over lines. You should know a thing or two about it. You're a line stepper too. You know what? I'm done talking. Last week, you got off easy. This week, I'm kicking your ass.
Here we go. Here we go.
Get your hands off me. You know, you've had it in for me since the beginning. You've never liked me, have you? You know, at SummerSlam, you called the match down the middle just until you saw an opportunity to screw me. So what's your problem, Hunter? Huh? Exactly. Why are you so scared of me being WWE champion? You afraid I'm going to be a good champion or a bad champion? You know, who's really pulling the strings? Is it you? Is it Big Sexy? Or is it your bean-headed wife? Mm.
I know you're a line crosser, and I've promised the world, including the board, that I wouldn't get involved in this stuff physically. But don't make the mistake of thinking that for a second, I'm not the same damn guy I've always been. I'm telling you right now, you cross a line with me, I'm gonna leave you lying where you stand.
Okay. All right, I wouldn't want you to take this nice suit off and fold it up and put it in your wife's purse where obviously you keep your cell phone as well as your balls.
Oh! What a blind shot from Kevin Nash taking down CM Punk.
Well, Punk said it himself. He loves to cross lines. He crossed one.
Kevin, I can take care of myself, right? You're not going to take this crap. You can't just let me see. I understand you're trying to hurt me.
Come on. Come on. Ladies and gentlemen. The confrontations continue tonight on Monday Night Raw. Their match at SummerSlam was called one of the greatest in the history of pay-per-view. Tonight they meet again in our main event. It is CM Punk versus John Cena. The winner becomes number one contender for the WWE Championship. They meet tonight live on Raw.
And speaking of championships, the WWE Tag Team Championships will be decided. Can Kingston and Bourne beat McGillicuddy and Otunga 2 weeks in a row? If they do, they become new tag champions. We'll find out next.
You can't be putting your hands on superstars. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, really? I mean, what, 4 weeks, man? Put on a suit and this is what, I mean, really?
Kev, I need you to go.
I never thought I'd say this, man, but you've changed.
This contest set for one fall is for the WWE Tag Team Championship!
Oh, Triple H may have lost a friend tonight.
Introducing the challengers first from China, West Africa, weighing 221 pounds, Kofi Kingston!
Jay, let me ask you simply, in your mind, has Triple H changed?
You want an honest yes or no?
Yes.
In my mind, yes.
I think for the better. I think he's got to do what he's got to do. What? Kevin Nash does not work here. He does not work here. Can't be punching people.
183 pounds. Evan.
Well, all I want to say about this is I believe that things have got completely out of control in this Punk Nash Triple H situation with Triple H being in charge. Punk's out here pushing buttons. There's a cheap shot. I mean, what a night it's been here on Monday Night Raw. And tonight Raw is brought to you by Just For Men. For mustache and beard, keep your edge.
And presented by 5-Hour Energy. The no wait, no hassle way to a great morning. Visit 5hourenergy.com.
WWE Tag Team Champions, David Otunga and Michael McGillicuddy.
Do you gentlemen realize that the Tag Team Champions have, well, held the titles for about 3 months ever since they defeated the Big Show and Kane all the way back at the end of May?
You know what? I agree. Defeating the Big Show and Kane was impressive, but since then, I mean, what dent have these two guys made on the WWE landscape? I mean, what do we know about either one of these guys? You remember the Bushwhackers? The Bushwhackers showed more personality in 5 seconds than these guys have shown in their entire career.
Well, I disagree completely with that. These men are the WWE Tag Team Champions.
Well, I would agree with you, but then we'd both be wrong. I said it last week, it's like the bland leading the bland. Do something,
guys. But King, the championships speak for themselves. Wouldn't you agree with that, too? The WWE Tag Titles are very prestigious. They should be coveted?
Oh, I'm sure they are coveted. They're coveted right now by Evan Bourne and Kofi Kingston.
And remember, Evan Bourne and Kofi Kingston knocked off the tag champs in a non-title bout last week, hence earning them this title opportunity tonight.
So it's McGillicuddy and Bourne starting it out. This is a one-fall match for the WWE Tag Team titles. Oh, nice athleticism by Bourne. Landed on his feet, came right back with those kicks to the quads, the thighs. Quick tag to Kofi Kingston.
Kofi a bit, well, JR-like today. He was extremely tweet-happy. Talking about this tag team championship opportunity here tonight. Said that if he and Evan win, it's like to create some sort of name for their team.
Well, I like that idea. I mean, let's face it.
Yeah, let's win first. Win first. How about that? Start with winning.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, if you're just joining us here tonight, live on Monday Night Raw, so much has transpired. We kicked off the night tonight.
When it could be right here.
With the Chief Operating Officer, Triple H, making a huge main event for later on.
Well, he sure did. Triple H has lined us up a rematch of the SummerSlam main event. It's going to be John Cena going against CM Punk. And the winner of that match is going to get the shot at the WWE Undisputed Champion, Alberto Del Rio. Look at this now.
And look at from behind McGillicuddy. And also, JR, we just saw moments ago, Triple H and his close friend Kevin Nash trying to air dirty laundry concerning what's been called TechScape over the past week or so. And boy, did that explode in their faces.
It really did, and we heard them. Take a look right here. Kofi Kingston got lured into a situation he shouldn't be in. And it may cost him a match right here. You know, Kevin Nash and Triple H have been such close friends for so many years. Triple H said he did not text Kevin Nash. Someone did. Who did? That's the question. And, but Nash doesn't work here.
Oh, Kevin didn't dispute it.
Well, nice teamwork there by Otunga and McGillicuddy.
Nash, I guess, just didn't like the attitude from CM Punk.
And Otunga going for the cover.
Tag team titles on the line here on Monday Night Raw. Again, the problem I'm having with this whole thing is that the CEO of Triple H, he's got to get a grip. He's got to get a handle on what's going on around here, especially in the situation between Punk and Nash. It's becoming extremely personal for Triple H. And you know how it is. If you're in charge of the company, you can't let personal issues cloud your judgment here.
And another cover pinning attempt. Exactly. And the issue there is that, you know, King, what I mentioned to you earlier is that, you know, Kevin Nash, even though he was an invited guest by the COO, he's a former WWE champion. The guy doesn't work here any longer.
Right.
I don't even know why he's here.
I think it's a good possibility that we may have seen the last of Kevin Nash, and hopefully we'll, without him around, we'll get to the bottom of this controversy. And right now, guys, this is proof of my point. You guys are sitting here talking about some totally different situation when the WWE Tag Team Champions, you know, these guys that are almost nameless are defending their titles.
Well, it's McGillicuddy and Otunga, Jerry. Mike McGillicuddy, a third generation superstar.
And McGillicuddy with a brilliant dropkick, almost perfect. Caught Kofi Kingston right in the mush. And I think McGillicuddy was speaking to you, King.
Yeah, he was, I'm sure, right? You know, I'm not gonna back down from anything I've said. If these guys come out here and show me something, show a little pizzazz. Come on.
Yeah, but there's something to be said about holding the tag team championship for 3 months.
How long has it been since we've seen them defend them? This is the first time I can remember in quite a while that the titles have been on the line.
And is that their fault?
Well, they've come out here and had a lot of matches and haven't, quite frankly, been very successful.
But again, is that their fault?
Maybe King's saying that Otunga and McGillicuddy should have been more proactive, more established, more of a body of work. And
let me say this, JR. Is it their fault that they haven't been successful? Yes, it's their fault.
But you keep saying they haven't been successful. They have been successful.
Did you see them? Where were you last week? What Raw were you watching?
Uh-oh. Otunga and Bourne.
Oh, Evan Bourne now.
Evan Bourne, former Missouri Tiger. And of course, they got Harvard represented by Otunga. A lot of intelligence.
You should be in heaven. You should be in heaven. This is like an NCAA game.
Not bad.
Evan Bourne and Kofi Kingston, both of these young men. Whoa! Look at Kofi Kingston! What athleticism there!
That may have eliminated McGillicuddy from the equation.
Oh! And that may eliminate. Oh. Wait a minute.
Bourne is legal.
Look out,
he's a legal man.
Look at this!
Eric Bourne!
Covering!
Tag titles at stake! And new champion! Bourne and McGillicuddy! Or excuse me, Bourne and Kingston!
And new WWE Tag Team Champions, Kofi Kingston and Evan Bourne!
Look around this arena, Michael Cole, not one person is sitting down. Everyone is on their feet. It's a standing ovation. These two kids are exciting. These two kids will set this tag team division on fire.
I agree with you. I mean, they defeated McGillicuddy and Otunga 2 straight weeks. They earned the opportunity here tonight.
And they took advantage of that opportunity.
Now let's see where the WWE Tag Team Division goes. That's the question. How will Bourne and Kingston represent the gold that they are now holding? A new journey is beginning for Evan Bourne and Kofi Kingston. And we're excited to go along with it.
Oh, what a night! What a great victory! New WWE Tag Team Champion!
Congratulations!
Yeah, I'm surprised you said it, Cole.
I told you they earned it.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is arguably the biggest main event in Monday Night Raw in years and years. And personally, for John Cena and CM Punk, it is the biggest main event they've ever had on Monday Night Raw.